There are several ways to collect results from a discrete event simulation model. In this video, I'm going to share with you the easiest way to get yourself up and running with results collection in your first model. I'm also going to share with you some tips about suppressing or displaying debug information as the simulation runs in order to improve user experience. So let's get going. First thing we'll do is we'll import Simpy, NumPy, and iter tools. And the first performance measure we're going to focus on is the mean waiting time for call operators. So we're going to do this in a very simple way. Each time a waiting time is recorded for a patient, we're going to store that in a list. And then at the end of the run, we're going to compute the mean waiting time from that list. The advantage of this approach is it's very simple. It's easy to implement in code. The downside is that for complex simulation with lots of events, there may be a large amount of data you need to hold in memory. So I'm going to implement this with a notebook level variable called results. That's going to be a dictionary object, and we're going to have a key per performance measure we would like to hold. So we have our first entry, which is waiting times, which is an empty list. Before we modify any of our model code, we're going to create a function called trace. Trace is going to wrap the print function. It's going to be a way for us to easily suppress or show the debug information that we're printing out as the simulation model runs. So the way this works is we have a constant value here called trace that we can set before we run our model, for example, in our run script. If that's set to true, we'll print out the debug information. And if it's set to false, we'll ignore that information and it will be suppressed. So we'll modify our service function first. So all we really need to do here is add a line of code that appends the waiting time of the current process for the call operator to our waiting times list. So if we scroll down, we just need to find where we were calculating that waiting time, and we need to add a new line in of code in here that stores that waiting time in the list. The second thing we're going to change in here is we're going to replace the print functions with trace. So this is going to call our trace function, which wraps print, and this debug information here, for example, the operator has answered the call, will either be shown or suppressed depending on how we want to run the simulation model. Our arrivals generator doesn't collect any results itself, but what we need to do in here again is replace our print function with the trace function. So here where we're printing out the call operator arrives, I only want to show that now if I'm running the model in trace mode. In the last version of the notebook, we had a script that ran the simulation model. We're going to replace that script with a function called single run. That's going to do the same operations as the script, but encapsulate it within a function and also add in some functionality to compute average results from the simulation run. It's also useful to have this within a function because we may want to run multiple replications of the model later on. And having a reusable function allows us to do that within a simple for loop. So I've got a skeleton of a function here called single run. That takes two parameters, the run length for the simulation model and an integer value representing the number of operators. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first create an instance of a SimPy environment and the resources and setup process as before. After we've done that, I'm going to print out that the simulation has completed. So now that we've run our simulation model, the next step is to calculate the run results using notebook level variables. So in this case, we're only calculating one, which is the mean waiting time for call operators. And we're just going to take the mean average of all the data that we've collected during the simulation run. And then at the end of the function, we return that mean waiting time to the calling code. So you can see how it's simple to set up a multiple replications version of this model from this single run function. So finally, we have a script that will run that model. Just to keep things neat, I'm resetting the notebook level variable here to be empty. I'm going to run the model for 1,000 minutes. We're going to have 13 call operators on duty. I'm going to suppress all debug information by setting trace to false. I'm going to call the single run function, pass in the run length and the number of operators, and return the mean waiting time. Print out simulation complete, and then show what the results are. So let's run that code. So we've got a waiting time for call operators of 3.8 minutes. If you'd like to rerun the simulation model, but this time see the debug output, you just need to toggle the value of trace to true and rerun. If you're enjoying the video and would like me to go through any other methods for collecting results from a discrete event simulation, perhaps you could comment below and give the video a like and subscribe. To calculate the utilization of call operators, we're going to follow the same procedure as for calculating waiting time. We're going to add a new entry to our results dictionary. We'll call that total call duration. We're going to modify our service function, and we're going to track the total call duration after each call completes. And then at the end of the run, we'll calculate the average operator utilization and then print the results to the screen. So if you'd like to have a go at that yourself, pause the video now and have a go at modifying the exercise notebook, link in description below. The first change I'm going to make is to the cell that sets up the notebook level variables for results collection. I'm going to add a new key value pair to the results dictionary that's going to hold the total amount of time that call operators are in use. The next change I need to make is to the service function. And here, all I'm going to do is update the running total of the total call duration that we're holding in our notebook level variable. This gives us the total time that all operators have been in use during the simulation run. So now that we'd like to generate multiple performance measures from our simulation model, it would be sensible to store those results within a dictionary object, because that will allow us to easily look up those values after the run is complete. We also need to add in some logic to actually calculate the proportion of time that call operators were busy during the run. And finally, we need to return all of those results to the calling code. So run results is our dictionary object that's going to contain an entry per key performance measure. We've made two small tweaks to the code there. The first is we're now storing the mean waiting time in our run results dictionary. The second change is that we've calculated operator utilization. So this value here represents the total time during the simulation run that the operators were available to take a call. And we've worked out the proportion of time that they were available. And this value here just makes sure that we get a value out of 100. Note that a small caveat to this is we're missing a slight bit of time at the end of the simulation run where there are calls in service that have not yet completed. So if that's important to you, you'd need to tweak your code slightly. And then finally, at the end of the function, we return the results dictionary. So to run that simulation model, I've got a pre-prepared script That script first sets up our results collection variable. That's there so that we can rerun this cell as many times as we need to. We have the run length, the number of operators. We're turning off any type of logging within the simulation model during its run. We're running the model using single run, returning that and storing it in a dictionary called run results. And then there's a bit of code at the end to iterate through those results and print them out. So let's run that. So we can see here that for this particular run of the simulation model, mean waiting time was 1.26 and operator utilization was quite high, around 91%. And if you run the model again, you'll get slightly different results because we're not controlling random numbers at this stage. Now that we've implemented basic results collection, there's a temptation to add more complexity to the model and immediately implement the rest of the call center logic. My recommendation is that you spend a bit of time implementing a high quality experimentation framework before you do this. This is going to make the model much easier to run in whatever way you would like, and also, importantly, make it easy to test your model. And this will be the subject of the next video.